George, this is an interesting kind of backstory about how and why this project came about.
Right.
How did that happen?
Well, we were all at the memorial of John Jones, and Coach Head asked us to come back to be recognized at Fisk University, the 75 championship team, which I played on.
Mm-hmm.
And when I went back and I looked around the yard, there was nothing about John Jones. And so I said, wow, well, I'm a filmmaker. Next year, we'll show a film about John Jones. And it did happen, but it didn't take off. And so it's been 10 years in making this film. And so that's how it got started.
Mm-hmm.
And as the research, and I got to talking with the other players, and I learned all these interesting stories.
Yeah.
And to know, I got to see John Jones one time. He came on the yard and he was talking to us, but he was talking about business.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the only time I got to see him other than when he played a Monday night football game with the New York Jets. And we were all proud of that.
I can imagine. People love a come from behind story where there's plenty of hurdles, plenty of obstacles, but you end up successful. Tell us some of the obstacles that you faced that maybe many of us have never experienced.
Well, I think that for us, growing up in Memphis, being divided, segregation, integration.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We went to high school at the time when segregation was dying. Integration was taking infancy steps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that was a chaotic time,
right,
I'm sure.
We went to Southside High School. Southside started in 1928. And every class that graduated from Southside had been, we'll say, all white classes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Within 3 years, the first graduating class from Southside, after integration, there were only 39 blacks and 150 white students because of the flight out of it.
Yeah. Mm.
And so we were cast into a situation with an administration and with teachers who hadn't taught folks who looked like us in the classroom.
Mm-hmm. Right.
One thing I wanted to ask both of you regarding that, at that time period, did you feel as if you were the lucky group of individuals there or not?
Well, we weren't really aware of it at the time because we were just trying to be a close-knit group.
Mm-hmm.
By us having an all-black team and all-white coaches during that time, that made us become even closer together. Wasn't really aware of it because we never saw ourselves play on TV or right. on film or anything like that.
Right.
We didn't know what celebrities we were and things like that until we got to be older.
Yeah.
Then we really realized this is the year after Dr. King was assassinated.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, black teams that we played against called us Uncle Toms, white teams would call us names and spit at us and things like that. So it was us against the world, so to speak.
Wow.
How did the white coaches handle that? This must have been sort of an awakening for them to realize that you were talented, you were intelligent, you were good kids, even though maybe they hadn't experienced African-American kids in their personal life.
I think the greatest example of that was Coach Ollie Smith. Not only did he was a genius, graduated from Mississippi State, he was a genius, but in our offenses and defensive schemes, he had always had his, we'll say the white kids who were intelligent. And then when he got the black kids, they were athletic, but they weren't intelligent.
Mm.
But when our group came in, he became a mad scientist.
Yes.
Really? I mean, and that year, our senior year, we dominated the city in such a fashion, every defensive mm-hmm. category. We played 13 different defenses and with variations on those because we had athleticism
yeah.
and the intelligence
so
to do it.
You guys had
that,
everything on
yeah.
the table there.
Through that, did you
That's
help
it.
Them end their own prejudices that maybe they didn't even recognize?
Certainly, there's
yeah.
no question about it.
For sure, but it still was a thing that was our team.
Yeah.
You know, the coaches, after practice, they just left the field, and we took care of everything mm-hmm. else.
So, George, what do you
remarkable.
Want the takeaway to be today from this film, from this project, and for those over at Fisk as they celebrate a huge anniversary? What do you want us all to kind of get from this?
The history. We're talking about a history of young men that left Memphis that couldn't go to any other school. And when it was my time, I couldn't be the quarterback at the University of Memphis, or Memphis State at the time, because they wasn't ready for a black quarterback. And it was the same with the guys at Southside. So we all ended up at Fisk. And this is a history I want everybody to take away, is John Jones was the fourth African-American quarterback in the NFL. And he came from right here in Memphis, Tennessee.
Wow.
They started at Lincoln Junior High, they were champions. Southside High School, they were champions. Fisk University, they were champions. They all graduated, and they all went to the NFL. Mm.
That's
so
awesome.
It's a historical thing. It was something that, and we all can thank Ms. Joyce Blackmon, Maceo Walker.
A lot of people.
Well, and there are a lot of people who come behind you who stand on your shoulders.
Exactly.
So Thursday, it's a great event. You have to come out and see the movie, The Lucky 11. We have put the information on the screen.
Now, you gentlemen all seem to be in great shape. Would you still be up for playing a little football today? Or wait a minute. George, you shake.
Well, I got one down. At least one down.
You got at least one down to play. At least one
down.
But you know, you must understand, there were six of us off there, one team, but to play professional football off there, one team.
Wow.
There were six guys.
That's amazing.
That is. That is incredible.
Taylor,
it really is.
John Jones, David the Spider-Man Boy, Terrell Millerton. I mean, those guys, and Avery Taylor played 8 years altogether, 4 years in each league. So.
Well, we're the lucky ones to have you right
by
here.
By all means.
Memphis.
The lucky 11,
so
for sure. Gentlemen, thank you very much for all that you have done and continue to do today.
Thank you.
We do
awesome
appreciate
story.
It.